Did you know you can send personalized mass emails in Gmail? Well, you can, and there are actually a couple of ways to do it. So this is your Gmail mail merge tutorial. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and enough Gmail content to make you wonder why other email providers even exist. Today, I'm showing you how to send personalized bulk emails in Gmail. So let's go. So as I mentioned at the top, there are actually a couple of ways to send bulk emails in Gmail, but let's start with the quickest and easiest way. And that's by utilizing a feature from the sponsor of today's video, Write Inbox. Write Inbox actually has 12 features, 9 of which are available for free, all of which supercharge your Gmail account. So first, you're going to want to head to writeinbox.com and click install for free in order to add Write Inbox to your Gmail. Now you're going to want to upgrade your plan in order to access Write Inbox's mail merge feature, but at about $6 per month, the upgrade is well worth it if you send a lot of recurring or bulk emails. Trust me. Once Write Inbox is installed, you're now going to have a mail merge option near the top left of your Gmail account. So simply click on that mail merge option, and here you can click on Create Campaign. First, I recommend titling your campaign, and this can just be whatever makes sense to you. There are really only 4 simple steps here. First, we're going to add recipients. You can either upload a CSV file or add recipients manually. If you do want to upload a CSV file, I'd recommend downloading the sample CSV that they provide so that you follow the proper formatting. But we'll talk a little bit about CSV files later. I think the easiest way to create a mail merge in Gmail is to add the recipients manually here. That way you're not worried about any coding or specific formatting. So we'll select add manually. Here, all we have to do is add the email addresses and names to the table. You can even add column names for additional information if you want. So if you had a specific vertical within this campaign, you could add that here. Once your table is all filled out, we're going to click on Create Sequence to move to step 2. Here, we'll simply compose our message. So we'll add a subject line, and now we'll add the body of the message. And by the way, if you've used the mail merge feature with Write Inbox before, you could also use the drop-down menu to the right of this load sequence option to select a specific sequence that you've used in the past. You can also save and exit at any time. So now let's insert the mail merge field. We're going to place our cursor where we want the recipient's name, and we'll click on the insert mail merge field option to the right, and then select name. Now, this is where you'd have other options if you added, you know, a vertical or date or whatever other column you added in step 1. But you can see that the name has been added between 2 curly brackets right where I wanted it. So anywhere you want a specific mail merge field to go, you're just going to click there in the body of the email and then select that mail merge field option. You can also add a follow-up message and choose when the follow-up message is going to be sent. I just love this feature too. So you can set it and forget it and let Write Inbox do all the work for you. Once you are ready to move on, click on Preview. In this step, we can preview each and every email to make sure it's personalized just the way we want. So to do so, just toggle through the arrows on either the left or right side of that email address bar. Now all that's left to do is send off the personalized bulk emails. Click on Confirm and Launch, and from here, let's select the date and time we'd like the first email to be sent at. We can also toggle on Link and Open Tracking, which are other great Write Inbox features, and then you can set your send rate here too. So if you're mass emailing to hundreds of people, you can send up to 250 per day. Toggle on the option where it says you understand that Gmail has a daily message limit, and then simply click on Start Mail Merge near the top right, and voila, that's how to send personalized bulk emails in Gmail. It's really so easy. And trust me, I am a cheap person, so I rarely pay for add-ons. But I'm telling you, if you send a lot of bulk emails out, just pay the $6 a month and let Write Inbox take care of all the formatting for you. And if you want more information on Write Inbox and all their features, you can head to writeinbox.com. So now let's learn how to send personalized bulk emails in Gmail for free. For this, we're gonna utilize a little developer trick and also a little help from Google Sheets. Warning, this takes a little bit longer and there are a few more steps, but like I said, it's free. The first thing we need to do is head to this Google Workspace for Developers page, which I have linked to in the description below. We're gonna scroll down to the Try It section and click on Make a Copy. This new Google Sheets page will come up asking if you'd like to make a copy of this document, which we do. So click on Make a Copy again, and now here we are in our Mail Merge spreadsheet. So now this is your own spreadsheet since you made a copy, so you can title it whatever you want. Like maybe you want to do this based on campaign, so you could change that, and you can really customize any of the headers and columns except for the recipient and email sent columns. So the recipient is where we're going to put in the email addresses of the recipients we're going to send to. And then the email sent column is going to give us a sent confirmation once the email is actually sent out. So let's use the magic of editing to fill out this spreadsheet according to our needs. So here we go. Now we have the spreadsheet filled out with first and last names, emails, the verticals the recipients fall under. And remember, we can change or remove any of these except for recipient and email sent. So maybe you want to change the vertical to a date field because maybe this is for an upcoming event. You could simply change this entire column to reflect that. So once you're all set in your Google Sheet, let's head over to our Gmail. You're going to proceed as usual in Gmail by composing an email you want to send in bulk. So once you have that all done, in the to field, we're going to put in two left curly brackets. Then we're gonna head back to our Mail Merge sheet, copy the recipient header cell. So select the header cell, hit Command C or Control C. Then let's head back to our Gmail and paste that in the to field right after our left curly brackets. Then let's close this with two right curly brackets. Notice there are no spaces anywhere in the to field. So what these curly brackets do is personalize anything within them. So anything within the brackets are going to be specified or unique, if you will. So we use the curly brackets for our to field because over here on the Mail Merge sheet, we want to send to these specific email addresses, so each one individually. So the curly brackets indicate that we want to send out to each of these recipients individually. Am I making sense? Are you following? Because we can apply the same theory for other uses in our bulk email. As an example, in the subject field, we can add them to our subject. So remember how we've got a vertical listed in the sheet? Well, maybe you want to specify that vertical in the subject line. So instead of what you must know now in order to grow, we could say something like what you must know now in order to grow. And then we could add our two left curly brackets, add vertical, and then close with our right curly brackets. So this will be replaced with the individual assigned vertical. Then we can do the same for their names in the body of the email. So, hey, curly bracket, first name, two more curly brackets. And remember, this is an exact copy of the header in the Google Sheet with caps and space and all. So if you changed your header, copy over that exact header and paste it between your curly brackets. So like I said, you can apply this method to anywhere in the body of this email as well. So if you wanted to mention the vertical again or the CID number or whatever other header you have, you could do that here. So we're just doing manually what Write Inbox did automatically for us. So now we want to actually send the emails out. So we're going to head back to our sheet and click on Mail Merge at the top, then click on Send Emails. In this pop-up, you're gonna have to authorize this action. So just press continue. choose your Google account, and then you might get this scary looking pop-up that the app isn't verified, but you can just rest assured this is safe. We got this from the Google Workspace for Developers page. So click on Advanced, then scroll down to select Go to Gmail Sheets Mail Merge option, then just click Allow. Now, before we actually send the bulk emails, I would encourage you to do these exact steps, but as a test. So send to yourself, another email address you have, maybe some friends, and make sure that everything is correct. So I'm gonna go ahead and assume you've done that, and we'll continue on with the bulk send. So now let's head back to Gmail and copy the subject line using Command C or Control C. Then back in our sheet, let's head back to Mail Merge and click on Send Emails. And now this time, paste that subject line of that Gmail draft using Command or Control V, then hit OK. That's all there is to it. Before you know it, the email sent column is going to populate with the date and timestamps that the email was sent at. Now you can just duplicate this every time you need to send a personalized bulk email for free. But remember earlier when we talked about creating a CSV file and uploading that with Write Inbox? Well, you can still create your table in Google Sheets, export that as a CSV, then upload that with Write Inbox. Now, it's still gonna be way easier than manually copy and pasting all these headers and curly brackets over from Sheets to Gmail. Either way, now you have a couple of options when it comes to sending bulk emails in Gmail. So that's your Gmail mail merge tutorial. Did you find this video helpful? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here and here for even more Gmail content. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.